We're back with some more new music. This time we got another track from the man himself, Eminem. We got another track off of Music to Be Murdered by Side B. I did react to his song Nat in the music video that he dropped with Lyrical Lemonade. So if you haven't seen that video, make sure you guys go and check that one out. And in that last track, that was more of a showcase of just Eminem's pure rap ability. He was just trying to flex on us his crazy penmanship and his lyricism and his flow and his delivery and his vibe and all of it. It was just Eminem flexing his pure rap ability, and I definitely thought that he absolutely killed in that song. Was definitely an absolute banger. This time we got a song here called Zeus. Hopefully this song is a banger, but if it's anything like that last song, I'm sure we're gonna be in for a real treat, and I'm definitely interested to see what we got today. If you guys like this video, make sure you spank the like and subscribe button and ring the bell so you guys get notified whenever I upload. And if you guys have any suggestions of videos you would like to see me do, make sure you leave those down in the comments below, because I'm open to anything. But without further ado, Zeus from Eminem, Music to Be Murdered by Side B. Let's see what we got.
She says I am trash, but she listens to Tekashi. Bitch, you lost me. Yeah, fair.
This is what we're doing. Eminem, Mr. Slim Shady, Marshall Mathers, sir. This is what we're doing. You really came through with the Music to Be Murdered by. You don't even give me a chance to get comfortable, get warmed up, get all nice and cozy, grab a nice snack, and cuddle up next to a fire. You don't even give me a chance to get all nice and comfortable with the track, and you already out here committing homicide. She say I'm trash, but she listened to Tekashi. Second number one, and he's already out here throwing shots. Jesus.
She says I am trash, but she listens to Tekashi. Bitch, you lost me. Yeah, fair weather, wishy-washy. She thinks machine washed me. Swear to God, man, her favorite rapper wish she crossed me. I love conflict, gotta
own. Wait.
Machine washed me. Swear.
She think machine washed me? Oh my gosh. Wait 7 seconds into this track, and he's already dissed two other rappers, bro. He's coming. He is coming for next. Everybody duck and cover. Eminem's coming through with the big guns.
Swear to God, man, her favorite rapper wish she crossed me. I love conflict, got her obnoxious. What? Subconscious, yeah. I'm afraid to unlock it. Keep those monsters in the closet. I'm what an idiotic. Got a sub on his mind. I've been throwing down gauntlets since that underground ruckus, yeah. Where I planted my roots.
Ooh.
Yeah. That's how I had a whole planet that roots for me. As in the group, and no one thinks dark as I think. Nah. So imagine the havoc these black thoughts are to wreak. As in Trotta, I keep slaughtering beach shots. To be honest and team honest, but me long as I pre-promise to be honest and wholeheartedly apologies. Oh. But that song that leaked, I'm sorry, Bri, it wasn't meant to cause you grief. Regardless, it was wrong of me, but I'd be on my
own. Oh my god, Eminem, relax, dude. Relax, Eminem, we get it, okay? You were the GOATs. You are a great, absolute, stellar rapper. You do not have to try to murder me, okay? You're supposed to be throwing shots at all these other rappers. You're not supposed to be threatening my life with those raging, burning flames that you're spitting at me, Eminem, okay? I get the point. I understand. You are a very good rapper. You don't got to come at me this hard. My fear for my life.
I'm sorry, Bri. It wasn't meant to cause you grief. Regardless, it was wrong of me. But
I'll be on my own.
Yeah.
Head up in the clouds like Zeus. When they say you ain't the GOAT, I come down like, ooh. But I got my head in the clouds like Zeus. Swear, I can see the game from a bird's eye view.
Who the fuck is this guy? Who the hell is this guy? I don't know who the hell this dude is, but oh my Jesus, this dude is so damn fire. Holy Jesus, I was not ready for that. I was not. What did he say?
But I got my head in the clouds like Zeus. Swear I can see the game down like boom.
Yeah.
Head up in the clouds like Zeus. When they say you ain't the GOAT, I come down like ooh.
When they say you ain't the GOAT, I come down like, who? Oh my gosh, bro, this dude is fire. Who the hell is this guy, bro? Who the hell is this guy?
You,
bro, this is fire. fire, but this song is so fire, dude.
Get back on my feet, don't wonder why in the fuck is my head in the clouds. G5 with the steward is getting head in the clouds. Mile high club, why I keep a flying fuck.
He said, I'm getting head in the clouds, mile high club. I love it. Mile high club.
I keep a flying fuck on punchline. I'm just trying to survive in this climate of vaginas. I'm dying to cancel my ass like Aunt Jemima. Syrup, I'm a shit stirrer, you're a dime.
He's coming for everybody, bro. Now he's coming for the cancel culture crazies on the internet, bro. He said, how am I supposed to survive in an environment of vaginas getting canceled like Aunt Jemima? Oh, my Jesus. Okay, he's literally murdering, trying to murder everybody, bro. Oh, my God. I hope everybody has their bulletproof vest on because Eminem's coming with the shots, bro. Eminem is coming with the shots, bro. He's speaking facts, you know what I'm saying? How could I survive in this climate of vaginas trying to get canceled like Aunt Jemima? You know what I'm saying? It seems like there's very little things that you can say on the internet without somebody trying to cancel you, without somebody trying to get outraged at you, somebody trying to ruin your career, just because you said something that they took offense to, that they don't agree with, or whatever. You know what I'm saying? It's definitely a huge issue in these modern times.
Couldn't do it. Hit Europe, kick the door and put a foot through it. Like a stirrup. Used to have to sit and watch them bills pile up. Yeah. Now I just sit back and watch them bills pile up. But I
be on my way. Used to sit and watch them bills pile up. Now I just sit and watch them bills pile up. Oh my gosh, Eminem, you need to relax, bro. Oh my gosh, this dude Eminem done sucked up all the fire out of the pits of hell, bro. This is ridiculous. Used to sit and watch them bills pile up. His rent, his car, his water, his electrical bill, his insurance, all them bills piling up. Now he just sits back and watch the money pile up. Oh my God, that's a glow up we love to see.
Pile up, yeah.
Now I just sit back and watch the bills pile up.
Zeus.
Go down like whoo,
my head in the clouds like Zeus, swear I can see the game
from the bird's eye view.
Bitch talking to a rap god.
Rap god,
you can give your whole damn life to the music thing. They gon' turn around. I've seen him come and go, I've seen the human.
Bro, I still don't know who the hell is singing on his hook, bro, but he is so damn fire, bro. He is so damn fire. He compliments this song so well, bro. Like, he's coming through with his own bars. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's not just a nice little catchy hook, you know what I'm saying, just to make the tune sound better. Like, he's actually coming with the bars, you know what I'm saying, seeing it all from a bird's eye view, you know what I'm saying, give your whole life to the gang and they just turn on you. This dude's coming with his own bars in his own right. If you gonna be on an Eminem song, you gotta come with the bars, and that dude definitely got him.
I've seen him come and go, I've seen the hugest debuts. I've had a great view to see the game through. And Drake, they're gonna turn on you one day too. And the more you win, the sooner they do.
Wait, what'd you say?
Debuts.
Okay, I thought he was throwing shots at Drake. I was like, hold up, he throwing shots at Drake? No, the old man has provided his words of wisdom upon the youth of the hip-hop game, you know what I'm saying? He's definitely giving Drake a heads up, you know what I'm saying? And it's absolute facts, you know what I'm saying? He's basically saying, hey, Drake, I'm just letting you know that they probably gonna treat you the same way that they've been treating me, you know what I'm saying? Because a lot of people who, you know, talk about Eminem, they say, yeah, he used to be good back in, like, the late 90s, early 2000s, even early 2010s, you know what I'm saying? But now his new stuff is trash. It's nothing compared to the old stuff that he makes. And he's saying, hey, Drake, it's probably gonna happen to you, you know what I'm saying? Drake is on top of the fucking world right now. One of the biggest superstars in hip-hop today, you know what I'm saying? Gets all kinds of crazy numbers on Spotify and shit like that, you know what I'm saying? But it's gonna come to a time when he hits like 45 years old and he's still pushing out music, and people are gonna be saying the same thing. They're gonna be acting like Drake's trash, and that his newer stuff, it cannot compare to any of his older stuff. You know what I'm saying?
Even if it is, once they start to turn their backs, they ain't never coming back. And they did it to Chance, next to be mentioned in future in the past tense. Or saying adios to amigos. I ain't dissing, I'm just trying to keep the shit a C-no. Same people been trying to do the shit to me, so I call them people because
they throw shots at the amigos too, bro. Oh my gosh. He's literally name dropping the hell out of everybody, bro. I ain't talking about the amigos.
But a fight is all I knew how to be. I got the shit beat out of me. Tripped and fell and blew out of knee. Popped it back in and hopped up like fuck it. Best 2 out of 3, yeah. Man, I gotta be doing something right. I got 11 years of sobriety. So the only bottom I'ma be hitting is if it's sodomy. Wait, I mean, you would think it's somebody.
I got 11 years of sobriety, so the only bottom I'm hitting is sodomy. Oh my Jesus, I'm not gonna survive. I've listened to the majority of this track. There's about a minute left. I don't know if I can survive the next minute. You see that blood? Do you see the blood on the album cover? Okay, that is my blood that had leaked from my body after it was completely incinerated by the flames that fucking Marshall Mathers is sitting here spitting at me, bro. That's, oh my Jesus. Oh my Jesus.
It's like fucking best 2 out of 3, yeah. Man, I gotta be doing something right. I got 11 years of sobriety, so the only bottom I'ma be hitting is if it's sodomy. Wait, I mean, you would think that somebody handed a sodomy. How I'm chopping these bars, they keep wanting me to rap responsibly when I'm constantly passing the buck like the fucking Dollar Tree. But I'ma always remind you that I came from poverty. Black people saved my life from the dark and Deshaun, and all that we want is racial equality. R.I.P.
Oh, I love that. Oh, I love that. I love that. He said, I came from poverty and black people saved my life and we need more quality. Shout out Eminem, bro. Shout out Eminem, bro. Eminem is for the people, bro. He's showing mad love. I appreciate that.
Saved my life from the dark and Deshaun, and all that we want is racial equality. R.I.P. Laquan McDonald, Trayvon and Brianna, Tatiana, Rayshard and Dominic, Eric Garner.
And now he's gonna sit here and name drop all of these. Oh my gosh, bro. Shout out Eminem, bro. This song is so damn crazy, bro. It's like a whole different mood switch. Like, the entire first part of this song was him literally slaughtering people in the rap game. You know what I'm saying? He's sitting here talking his shit, writing, you know, sort of the normal Eminem diss track. And in this one, he's showing mad love. You know what I'm saying? He's saying, rest in peace, Brianna, Trayvon, you know what I'm saying, Eric Garner. He's name dropping all of these, you know what I'm saying, people that were victims of racial injustice, you know what I'm saying. So just the fact that he sort of switched the mood and still made it seem like all smooth and cohesive, bro, there's nobody like Eminem, bro. There's, this dude is so damn crazy.
Rodney King, no, we can't get along to these white motherfucking cops who keep murdering blacks off the streets. And as far as squashing beef, I'm used to people knocking me, but just not in my camp. And diplomatic, cause I'm trying to be last thing I need a Snoop dogging me. Man, dog, you was like a damn god to me.
Is he about this Snoop Dogg? I know he's not about to diss the Snoop D-O-double-G. Oh no, this is okay. Okay, this might cause World War III, bro. This is, oh my gosh.
The last thing I need is Snoop dogging me. Man, dog, you was like a damn god to me. Man, not really. I had dog backwards.
He said you was like a god to me. Nah, not really. I just had dog backwards. Bro, this dude, Eminem does not give one single fuck, bro. He D, oh my
man,
Jesus.
Dog, you was like a damn god to me. Man, not really. I had dog backwards. I'm starting to think all these people taking shots at me. Shit, it's no wonder I be on my own.
Oh my gosh. Bro, why is he dissing Snoop Dogg? Why is he dissing the big D-O-double-G? What'd he say? He's talking about all these people throwing shots at me. That's why I be staying on my own. You know what I'm saying? Did Snoop Dogg say something? What did Snoop say, bro? That's crazy.
Shots at me. Shit, it's no wonder I be on my own.
Head up in the clouds like Zeus when they say you ain't the goat.
Coming down like,
but I got my head in the clouds like Zeus. Swear I can see the game
from a bird's eye view.
Hey. Talking to a rap god.
Rap god.
Talking to a rap star. Hey, you could give your whole damn life to the music thing. They gon' turn around like they don't love you.
Yo, alright, bro. We got an absolute banger here from the man Eminem, and I definitely think that this is a song that proves that this man still has it, bro. Like I said at the beginning, the last song I reacted to from him, it was more of just a showcase of his talent. You know what I'm saying? Crazy penmanship and wordplay and lyricism and flow. This time, we got all of that absolute madness, plus add on top of it that he was actually talking about some stuff in this song, man. First of all, he's taking shots at people. He said, she called me trash, but she listened to Tekashi. Really, that's all he needed to say to get his point across right there, bro. And then he said, she think machine washed me. That was crazy. That bar was crazy. He was throwing shots at the Migos at one point. I feel like he was dissing the hell out of Snoop Dogg, bro. That was crazy. And then at one point, he was sort of letting Drake know, hey, all these people, they loved me. I was on top of the world. I was dropping banger after banger, slapperooski after slapperooski. But now that I'm old, people say that I don't drop the same sort of stuff that I did, that I used to, and my new stuff is worse than my old stuff, which I definitely could see what he's talking about. Definitely see a lot of people on the internet talk about how Eminem is not what he used to be, and I guess I kind of agree with that, but I don't think that he's completely trash like some people do. You know what I'm saying? He definitely is not the same Eminem from, you know, the 2000s, but I definitely think he's still super, super dope, as we have seen here today, man. And he was talking about like cancel culture and that kind of stuff, man. I don't know who the hell was doing the hook on this song, like I said, bro, but I need some more of him, because that guy was definitely so fire. Not only was the hook, like, super catchy and just, you know what I'm saying, he was doing his thing, but he also had the bars, too. You know what I'm saying? They say I'm not the GOAT, so I come down like, who? If I'm not the GOAT, who is it then? Who is it? I'm seeing the whole game from a bird's eye view, bro. That dude was definitely so fire and was definitely a nice little touch. Added a nice little razzle dazzle to this song, man. And this song was just so, so crazy. Definitely think that this is, you know what I'm saying, Eminem's sort of ultimate form when he sort of puts it all together. The disses, you know what I'm saying, the he's telling stories, he means something, he's got the crazy wordplay and the bars and the writing and the flow and the delivery, all of it. This is sort of where I feel like Eminem really shines, man. And overall, definitely thought that this song was an absolute banger, and I did really enjoy this. Let me know what you guys thought of this song down in the comments below. Did you like it? Did you hate it? Did you like some of it? Did you hate some of it? Let me know what you guys are feeling. I'm interested to hear what you guys have to say. Like I said at the beginning, if you guys have any suggestions or videos you would like to see me do, make sure you leave those down in the comments below. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to spank the like, subscribe button, ring the bell, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.